Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjalai Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the solution and discussion on gate question paper in Mechanical Engineering. And this is lecture number 33. So we are going to discuss few problems or questions in conduction heat transfer from various gate question paper. So in the earlier lecture also we discussed the conduction heat transfer, so we will continue with the previous discussions. The first problem from 2009 question paper: consider the steady state heat conduction across the thickness in a plane composite wall as shown in the figure, exposed to convection conditions on both sides. So given that HI equal to 20 watts per meter square Kelvin, HO equal to 50 watts per meter square Kelvin, T infinity I 20 degree Celsius, T infinity O minus 2 degree Celsius, thermal conductivity of the first slab K1 equal to 20 watts per meter Kelvin, second slab K2 equal to 50 watts per meter Kelvin, L1 thickness of the first slab L1 equal to 0.3 meter and L2 equal to 0.15 meter. Assuming negligible contact resistance between the wall surface, the interface temperature T in degree Celsius of the two walls will be, there are four options: minus 0.5, 2.75 degree Celsius, 3.75 degree Celsius and 4.5 degree Celsius. The answer is 3.75 degree Celsius. So the interface temperature for this configuration, the heat transfer, the interface temperature between the two slab is 3.75 degree Celsius. So we will see how in the next slide. And this is the configuration given, these are all the data given, and the interface temperature is T. Now the heat transfer per unit area across the composite slab. So we have Q by A equal to the Ti minus T divided by, so here the, from the heat transfer, we want to calculate the temperature here, we consider the resistances up to the temperature T. So Ti minus T divided by 1 by Hi plus L1 by K1. So the convection resistance on the inside and the conduction resistance due to the first surface, first slab. This is equal to T minus TO divided by L2 by K2, conduction resistance due to the second slab and the convection resistance on the outside. So the substituting numerical values, 20 minus T divided by 1 by 20 plus 0.3 divided by 20. So HI equal to 20. K1 is also 20. So HI equal to 20, K1 is also 20, and 0.3 is the thickness of the first slab. So my T minus is equal to T minus of minus 2. So TO equal to minus 2 degree Celsius. Minus of minus 2 divided by 0.15 divided by 50 plus 1 by 50. Now 20 minus T divided by 1 by 20 plus 0.3 divided by 20 is equal to T plus 2 divided by 0.15 divided by 50 plus 1 by 50 and calculating. Actually, so here the two denominators are 20. We take 20 as a common denominator. So 1.3 divided by 20. Here it will be 1.15 divided by 50. So denominators are equal. So the 20 will go to the numerator. So 20 into 20, 400 minus 20T divided by 1.3 equal to 50T plus 50 into 200 divided by 1.15. Now we cross multiplying, 1.15 into 400 minus 20T equal to 1.3 into 50T plus 100. Now multiplying, 460 minus 23T equal to 65T plus 130. So 88T equal to 330 and T temperature, interface temperature equal to 3.75 degree Celsius. So this is the answer. So the mark is only 2 marks for the question. So but you have to spend maximum of 2 minutes. So within the 2 minutes you have to quickly calculate, quickly substitute and calculate using the virtual calculator in the computer. Heat is being transferred convectively from a cylindrical nuclear reactor fuel rod 50 mm diameter to water at 75 degrees Celsius under steady state conditions. The rate of heat generation within the fuel rod is 50 into 10 power 6 watts per meter cube and the convective heat transfer coefficient is 1 kilowatt per meter square Kelvin. The outer surface temperature of the fuel element would be 700 degrees Celsius. 625 degree Celsius, 550 degree Celsius and 400 degree Celsius. There are four options available. We have to calculate. The answer is 700 degree Celsius. So the outer surface temperature of the fuel element would be 700 degree Celsius. We will see how in the next slide. So given that the diameter of the fuel rod 0.05 meter, surface temperature, water temperature is 75 degree Celsius. The heat generator is 15 10 power 6 watts per meter cube. And heat transfer coefficient is 1000 watts per meter square Kelvin. And the heat conducted to the outer surface of the cylinder is equal to heat convected to the water from the surface. So heat conducted towards the outer cylinder is equal to amount of heat generated into volume. That is equal to amount of heat convected to the water equal to HA into TS minus TW. So substituting the values, QG into volume equal to pi by 4 D square into L, which is equal to H pi D into L. So surface area of the cylinder is pi D into L in TS minus T infinity. Substituting all the numerical values, 50 into 10 power 6 in 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.05 square into 1. We take length of the cylinder equal to fuel rod equal to 1 meter. So 1000 into 3.14 into 0.05 into 1 into TS minus 75. So calculating 98125 equal to 157 into TS minus 75. So TS minus 75 equal to 625 degree Celsius. So surface temperature TS equal to 700 degree Celsius. This is the answer to the problem. The next question from 2014 question paper. A material P of thickness 1 millimeter is sandwiched between two steel slab as shown in the figure below. So we have two steel slab, in between we have a material of thickness 1 millimeter. Heat flux 10 kilowatts per meter square is supplied to one of the steel slab as shown. So here 10 kilowatts per meter square heat flux is supplied. The boundary temperature of the slab indicated in the figure, assuming the thermal conductivity of the steel is 10 watts per meter Kelvin, considering one dimensional steady state heat conduction for the configuration, the thermal conductivity of the material P is dash watts per meter Kelvin. So look at this slab. So we have a three slabs now, steel slab, and we have the slab of material P and again steel slab. So thickness is 20 millimeter here, and the left side temperature is 500 Kelvin, right side temperature T2 equal to 360 Kelvin, and here the heat flux equal to 10 kilowatts per meter square. Now we have to calculate thermal conductivity of the material P. And it is 0.1 watts per meter Kelvin. So the thermal conductivity of the material is 0.1 watts per meter Kelvin. So we will see how in the next slide. So this is the slab what is given, and the given data, thickness of the slab P, LP equal to 1 millimeter, and thermal conductivity of the steel equal to 10 watts per meter Kelvin. So the heat flux Q equal to T1 minus T2 divided by all the three resistances. So LS by KS plus LP by KP plus LS by KS. So the three slabs. LS, so S stands for steel and the P stands for the material P. So the heat flux is 10,000. So the heat flux is given as 10,000 watts per meter square. That is 10 kilowatts per meter square. So it is equal to 500 minus 360. So temperature 500 Kelvin minus 360 Kelvin divided by, substituting all numerical value excepting Kp. Kp is the thermal conductivity of the material P, which is unknown. So 0.02 divided by 10 plus 0.001 divided by Kp plus 0.02 divided by 10. So this will be 140 divided by 4 into 10 power minus 3 plus 0.001 divided by Kp. So cross multiplying 10,000 into 4 into 10 power minus 3 plus 0.001 divided by Kp equal to 140. So multiplying, so 40 plus 10 by Kp equal to 140. So Kp equal to 10 by 100 equal to 0.1 watts per meter Kelvin. So the thermal conductivity of the material P is 0.1 watts per meter Kelvin. The next question again from 2014 question paper. The heat transfer through a composite wall is shown in the figure. Both the sections of the wall have equal thickness L. So L is the thickness of the slab. The conductivity of one section is K, and that is for another one is 2K. So here K is thermal conductivity and 2K is thermal conductivity here. The left face of the wall is at 600 Kelvin and right face is 300 Kelvin. So 600 Kelvin, 300 Kelvin. The interface temperature Ti of the composite wall is dash. So what is the temperature Ti at the interface? So the answer is 400 Kelvin. So the answer is 400 Kelvin. We will see how in the next slide. So the composite slab is shown here, the same diagram. Now the heat transfer rate per unit area Q by A equal to, so for the first slab T1 minus T8 divided by L by K equal to TI minus T2 divided by L by 2K. So substitute numerical value is 600 minus T8 divided by 1. So the L equal to 1, K so L by K is getting cancelled. L is cancelled. K is also cancelled from the two equations. So left hand side we have 1 and right hand side 1 by 2 which is 0.5. So 600 minus TA divided by 1 equal to TA minus 300 divided by 0.5. So cross multiplying 0.5 into 600 is 300. So 0.5 TI equal to TA minus 300. So 1.5 TA equal to 600. So TI equal to 400 Kelvin. So the temperature interface temperature TI equal to 400 Kelvin. And this is the answer to the problem. Next question from 2014 question paper. A plain wall has a thermal conductivity of 1.15 watts per meter Kelvin. If the inner surface is at 1100 degrees Celsius and the outer surface is at 350 degrees Celsius, then the design thickness in meter of the wall to maintain the steady heat flux of 2500 watts per meter square should be dash. So the given data, thermal conductivity is 1.15 watts per meter Kelvin. Temperature T1 equal to 1100 degrees Celsius, T2 equal to 350 degrees Celsius, and the heat flux equal to 2500 watts per meter square. So the heat flux Q by A equal to T1 minus T2 divided by L by K. So L by K equal to T1 minus T2 divided by Q. So 1100 minus 350 divided by 2500 equal to 0.3. So L equal to 0.3 times of K. So 0.3 into 1.15 equal to 0.345 meter. So the thickness of the slab required is 0.345 meter. This is the answer to the problem. The next question from 2015 question paper. A 10 mm diameter electrical conductor is covered with an insulation of 2 mm thickness. The conductivity of the insulation is 0.08 watts per meter Kelvin and the convection heat transfer coefficient at the insulation surface is 10 watts per meter square Kelvin. Addition of further insulation of the same material will increase the heat loss continuously, decrease the heat loss continuously, increase the heat loss to the maximum and then decreases the heat loss, decrease the heat loss to a minimum, then increase the heat loss. So the correct option is increase the heat loss to the maximum, then decrease the heat loss. So we'll explain why or how in the next slide. And this is all the data given. Radius of the wire R equal to 0.005 meter. Outer radius of the insulation RO equal to 0.005 plus 0.002 equal to 0.007 meter. Thermal conductivity of the insulation K equal to 0.08 watts per meter Kelvin. And the heat transfer coefficient is 10 watts per meter square Kelvin. The critical radius of insulation for the data given RC equal to K by H. So 0.08 divided by 10 equal to 0.008. So the critical radius of insulation is 0.008, whereas the outer radius of insulation in the present situation is 0.007. So further adding the insulation, so look at the configuration and this is R1 equal to the we have outer radius R1 equal to 0.005 meter. And we are somewhere here, so the insulation, so 0.007 somewhere here, but the critical thickness is 0.008, so the critical thickness here it is 0.008 meter. Now, so we are here with the insulation 0.007 meter, so further adding the insulation, it will increase the heat transfer, reaches the maximum value and then it decreases, that is the solution. So we are the now with the insulation the outer radius is 0.007. So when the thickness is increased, when the radius is increased to 0.008 meter, the heat transfer will be maximum, then the heat transfer will decrease. So the heat transfer increases up to RC and then decreases. That is the conclusion to the question. The next question from 2015 question paper. A cylindrical uranium fuel rod of radius 5 mm in a nuclear reactor generating heat at a rate of 4×10⁻⁷ watts per meter cube. The rod is cooled by a liquid of convective heat transfer coefficient 1000 watts per meter square Kelvin at 25 degrees Celsius at a steady state. The surface temperature of the rod in Kelvin is, we have 308, 398, 418, 448 Kelvin. So the correct answer is 398 Kelvin. So we will see how in the next slide. So we are given R equal to 5 millimeter, 0.005 meter. Water temperature 25 degrees Celsius, heat generated 4×10⁷ watts per meter cube, heat transfer coefficient is 1000 watts per meter square Kelvin, and the heat conducted to the outer surface of the uranium rod is equal to heat conducted to the liquid. So we have Qg into volume equal to Ha into Ts minus Tw. So Qg into pi r square into L, volume equal to pi r square into L, which is 2 pi H into surface area 2 pi r into L into Ts minus Tw, that is liquid temperature. Now 4×10⁷ into 3.14 into 0.005 square into 1 meter length. So 1000 into 2 into 3.14 into 0.005 into 1 into Ts minus 25. So calculating. Left hand side is 3140, right hand side is 31.4 into Ts minus 25. So Ts minus 25 equal to 100. So Ts equal to 125 degrees Celsius, which is 398 Kelvin. So this is the answer to the problem. The next question from 2015 question paper. A brick wall of thermal conductivity 0.9 watts per meter Kelvin of thickness 0.18 meter separates warm air in a room from the cold ambient air. On a particular winter day, the outside air temperature is minus 5 degrees Celsius. The room needs to be maintained at 27 degrees Celsius. The heat transfer coefficient associated with the outside air is 20 watts per meter square Kelvin. Neglecting convective resistance of the air inside the room, the heat loss in watts per meter square is dash. We have four options, 88, 110, 128, 160 watts per meter square. So the correct answer is 128 watts per meter square. So we will see how in the next slide. So this is the configuration. We have the wall thickness. So inside surface temperature record is 27 degrees Celsius. We have ambient, which is atmospheric air, outside, which is minus 5 degrees Celsius with a heat transfer coefficient 20. And the wall thickness is 0.18 meter. So K thermal conductivity is 0.9 watts per meter Kelvin. So heat transfer per unit area Q by A equal to T1 minus TA divided by L by K plus 1 by H. So we have to calculate heat flux. So T1 27, TA is minus 5. So minus of minus 5 divided by L by K. L equal to 0.18 divided by 0.9 plus 1 by 20. So 32 divided by 0.25 equal to 128 watts per meter square. So the heat transfer per unit area is 128 watts per meter square is the answer to the question. Next question, again 2015 question paper. In a 1 meter thick wall, the temperature distribution at a given instant is given by T of x equal to CO plus C1x plus C1x square, where T is the temperature in degrees Celsius and x is the distance in meter. The constant CO equal to 18 degrees Celsius, C1 equal to minus 250 degrees Celsius per meter, and C2 equal to minus 40 degrees Celsius per meter square. The thermal conductivity of the wall is 50 watts per meter Kelvin, and the wall area is 5 meter square. If there is a heat source generating uniform volumetric heating at the rate of 500 watts per meter cube inside the wall, then the rate of energy storage in the wall in kilowatt is dash. So we are given certain condition, we have to calculate the amount of energy stored within the wall. The answer is minus 17.5 kilowatt. Now we will see how in the next slide. And the constant, so given data, constants are CO 800, C1 equal to minus 250 degrees Celsius per meter, C2 equal to minus 40 degrees Celsius per meter square. T
thermal conductivity in the wall is 50 watts per meter Kelvin, area equal to 5 meter square, length equal to 1 meter, volume is area into L, so 5 meter cube, and amount of heat generated is 500 watts per meter cube. And this is the temperature profile given. Now we differentiate. So dT by dx equal to C1 plus 2C2x. And again differentiate, d square t by dx square equal to 2C2. So 2 into minus 40 equal to minus 80. So d square t by dx equal to minus 40. So one dimensional unsteady state heat conduction with the heat generation. The equation for one dimensional unsteady state heat conduction with the heat generation. So dou square t by dou x square plus qg by k equal to 1 by alpha dou t by dou t. So dou square t by dou x square plus qg by k equal to alpha equal to k by rho c. So rho c by k into dou t by dou t. So multiply the equation by vk. So v is the volume, k is the thermal conductivity. So vk into dou square t by dou x square plus v into qg equal to v into rho c into dou t by dou t. So v into rho is the mass. So mass into specific heat into dou t by dou t is the amount of heat stored within the solid. So rho v rho c dou t by dou t is the amount of heat stored. So amount of heat stored equal to vk into dou square t by dou x square plus v into qg. So substituting v volume equal to 5 meter cube, k equal to 50, and dou square t by dou x square already we have calculated minus 80 plus volume again 50 into 500. So calculating minus 17,500 watts, which is minus 17.5 kilowatts. So the amount of energy stored within the slab equal to minus 17.5 kilowatts. Next question from 2017 question paper. Heat generated uniformly in a long cylindrical rod of diameter 10 mm at a rate of 4 into 10 power 7 watts per meter cube. The thermal conductivity of the rod material is 25 watts per meter Kelvin. Under steady state conditions, the temperature difference between the center and the surface of the rod is dash degree Celsius. So the given data, radius equal to 5 millimeter, which is 0.005 meter. Heat generation equal to 4 into 10 power 7 watts per meter cube and thermal conductivity is 25 watts per meter Kelvin. Now the temperature difference between center and the surface temperature of the rod. So this is the problem of one dimensional steady state heat transfer, heat conduction with the internal heat generation. So the temperature difference TO minus TS, TO is the center temperature which will be the maximum temperature and TS is the surface temperature. Equal to qg r square by 4k. Qg is the amount of heat generated, r square divided by 4k. So 4 into 10 power 7 into 0.005 square divided by 4 into 25. That is equal to 10 degree Celsius. The temperature difference between the center and the surface equal to 10 degree Celsius. This is the answer to the problem. The next question from 2018 question paper. A plane slab of thickness L and the thermal conductivity K is heated with a fluid on one side P and the other side Q is maintained at the constant temperature TQ equal to 25 degrees Celsius as shown in the figure. The fluid is at the 45 degrees Celsius and the surface heat transfer coefficient is 10 watts per meter square Kelvin. The steady state temperature TP is 0 degrees Celsius of the side which is exposed to the fluid. The steady state temperature TP in degree Celsius of the side which is exposed to the fluid is dash. So what is the temperature at the TP? That is the question. Correct to two decimal places. So we have to calculate the temperature here. So here left hand side we have the convection heat transfer. So HE equal to 10 watts per meter square Kelvin and T infinity equal to 45 degrees Celsius. And this surface is maintained TQ equal to 25 degrees Celsius. And the slab of thickness 20 cm and thermal conductivity 2.5 watts per meter Kelvin. So the answer is 33.89 degrees Celsius. So we will see how in the next slide. So this is the configuration. We have a slab of 0.2 meter 2.5 watts per meter Kelvin. And here we have the air at the 45 degrees Celsius. 10 watts per meter square Kelvin. Tp is the temperature on the surface here. We have to calculate Tp and Tq is 25 degree Celsius. So, the heat transfer per unit area. So, Q by A equal to Ta minus Tp divided by 1 by H. So, the convection heat transfer on the left side is equal to Tp minus Tq divided by L by K. So, the convection to the left side of a surface equal to conduction between these two end surfaces. So, this equal to 45 minus Tp divided by 1 by 10 equal to Tp minus 25 divided by 0.2 divided by 2.5. So, this is 0.1. So, 45 minus Tp divided by 0.1 equal to Tp minus 25 divided by 0.08. So, cross multiplying 0.08 into 45 minus Tp equal to 0.1 into Tp minus 25. So, 3.6 minus 0.08 Tp equal to 0.1 Tp minus 2.5. So, 0.18 Tp equal to 6.1 and Tp, the temperature of the surface P equal to 33.89 degree Celsius. The next question from 2019 question paper, three slabs are joined together as shown in the figure. We have three slabs of each thickness 1 meter. The central slab experiences non-uniform internal heat generation with the average value of 10,000 watts per meter cube. While the left and right side, right slabs have thickness equal to 1 meter and thermal conductivity of each slab is equal to 5 watts per meter Kelvin. The two extreme faces are exposed to the fluid with the heat transfer coefficient 100 watts per meter square Kelvin and the bulk temperature is 30 degree Celsius as shown in the figure. So, left side we have 100 watts per meter square, 30 degree Celsius and here again 100 watts per meter square Kelvin, 30 degree Celsius. The heat transfer in the slab assumed to be one dimensional steady and all properties are constant. If the left extreme face is T1 equal to 100 degree Celsius, so the surface is 100 degree Celsius. The right extreme surface T2, the temperature T2 equal to dash degree Celsius. So, we have to calculate the temperature here on the surface T2.
The temperature is 60 degree Celsius. So, the temperature T2 equal to 60 degree Celsius. We will see how in the next slide. So, this is the configuration. The amount of heat generated equal to 10,000 watts per meter cube. The heat generated in the slab is equal to heat convected from the sides. So, the heat generator equal to Qg into volume of the composite slab. So, the heat convected from both sides. So, the left side T1 minus 30 divided by 1 by Ha and here T2 minus 30 divided by 1 by Ha. So, 1 by Ha is a common term. So, the Qg into A into L, volume equal to A into L. So, the Ha is a common term, it goes to numerator. So, Ha into T1 minus 30 plus T2 minus 30 and Qg into L, A is getting cancelled, both left side and right side. So, Qg into L equal to H into T1 plus T2 minus 60. Now, you substitute Qg equal to 10,000 into length equal to 1 meter. Length is perpendicular to the board, perpendicular to the screen. So, 1 meter and this equal to H equal to 100 into 100 plus T2 minus 60. So, this will be 40. So, this is 100 minus 60 equal to 40 plus T2 equal to 10,000 divided by 100 equal to 100. So, the T2 equal to 60 degree Celsius. That is the answer. The temperature of the surface T2, it is 60 degree Celsius. And we stop here. So, these are all the books I have published in the mechanical engineering subject. And I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures of all the subjects mentioned here and the solution to the gate question paper is also uploaded in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better preparation and pass in the gate examination. Thank you for watching. So, please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. So, we'll meet again in the next video on the solution on conduction heat transfer.